Hello everyone! In this video you can watch me create two resin geode trays, and I'm also going to use two inlay molds, silicon inlay molds, that I will be dry brushing with my new chameleon pigment pens. So for the new people to my channel that like tutorials of resin in this case, but I also have tutorials of acrylics, mixed media, alcohol ink, and a lot more other tutorials, consider to subscribe. Don't forget to click the notification bell and select all, because that way you don't miss any future videos that I will be uploading to my channel. So what I already mentioned, I'm going to use 5 chameleon colors, and I'm using my one of my newer items that I will be adding to my Etsy shop. It are chameleon pigment pens, and the first color I'm using is a color that shifts from a wine red orange color to a magenta color. And yeah, these pens are amazing, because in the lid of the pen there is pressed pigment, chameleon pigment, and on the top of the pen there is a sponge, and when you twist the sponge in the lid, then you will pick up the pigment, and then you can add it where you want to. So in this case I'm adding it on top of it of the inlay mold, and these inlay molds are from Molds and Shapes. Also the geode tray molds are from Molds and Shapes, so if you're interested, all the information to their website is in the description box. And I also have a promo code for their website. If you use my code JUSTPAINT5, then you will get 5% discount on your total value order. So the second color I've used is a color that shifts from turquoise to purple, but also a little bit of pink. And the color I'm using now is a color that shifts from green, a nice green, to a blue. So these pens are really so easy to use. You can see me do it. I'm brushing it on top of the inlay mold, and this one is called Crushed Ice, the inlay mold. So I took the inlay molds out of the silicon tray molds, and yeah, because that way I don't get pigments on the tray mold. Yeah, I'm so pleased that I will be adding these pigment pens to my Etsy shop. Yeah, first I will get 6 colors. I'm showing you in this video 5 colors, but I will get 6 chameleon colors, but I will also get gold and silver. But these look very nice. Yeah, and this is the second time I'm using these pigment pens to test them. This inlay mold has another structure, a different one. And this color shifts from magenta to purple, but also a little bit of orange in it. At the end of the video I will show you a close-up, and then you can see it much better. But so you can see, it goes on very easy. And what I also like about these pigment pens is that the pigments don't fly around in your face. And another color, dark blue. Little bit of purple, but also a little bit of green. Very nice. So I also want to thank Molds and Shapes for sending me these amazing inlay molds, but also the geode tray molds. So thank you so much, Molds and Shapes, for sending me these amazing quality silicon molds. So a little bit further in the process, almost done with the Chameleon Pigment Pen colors. And this is an experiment. I don't know how it will look at the end, but we will find out together. But so far it looks very pretty. So I place the inlay molds back into the geode tray molds, and now I'm adding some abalone shells on the edge. Also these shells you can find in my Etsy shop. The link to my Etsy shop is in the description box below this video. This is a nice peacock color, and I will be getting more colors of the abalone shells, but for now only one color. They are also available in the Etsy shop of my associate in the USA. So that's great for the people that live in the USA and Canada. And the geode tray molds are in three different sizes. I'm using the smaller one and the middle size. But there is also a larger size. So if you're curious, please check out their website. They have a lot of amazing silicone molds. The link to their website of Molds and Shapes is below this video. So I'm placing those abalone shells on the edge, all the way around. And these have some amazing colors. What I need to say about these abalone shells, if you use them in resin, they will get a much vibrant color than you can see now. Or if you use a gloss varnish on top of it, or on top of the shells. But I think they already look amazing without resin. And I'm also going to add some glitter lines, and I'm using the FIFA Decor glitter pen, and this is in the color copper. So next to the abalone shells I'm adding a line. I think that will look nice. But yeah, it's an experiment. We will find out at the end of the video if it all turned out well. And also a glitter line in the smaller geode tray, and this is in the color ocean blue. I think these glitter pens are amazing. You can use them in a mold, but also on top of resin. And if you want really fine lines, then this glitter pen is very suitable for it. And give you a nice effect. So now I'm going to pour some resin in the molds, and this is also an experiment because I never used opaque resin on top of the abalone shells, so we will find out. So I'm using black, and I mixed in some of the Twinkling Forest, one of my own natural mica pigments, so that it will get a nice cream shade. And some sparkle, of course. So hopefully this will also give me a nice effect with the abalone shells and the chameleon pigment pens. And the other one I'm using, again, black, and I mixed in some of my amethyst mica pigment, so it will get a purple sheen, and some sparkle, of course. As you all know, I love sparkle. But the colors of the chameleon pigment pens are amazing and really easy to use. I like this much better than if you add pigment on your silicon mold with a silicon brush or whatever, the loose pigments. This is so much easier. So the heat gun to remove some air bubbles. And now I'm going to add more resin because I need to fill it. Not all the way to the top, because this will get a heat resistant layer on both sides. But I'm going to show you as much as I can of the process. So if you want to fast forward, I don't have a problem with that. There you can see it on top of the inlay mold. And the resin I'm using is the Art Pro resin from the Resin Pro company. Medium viscosity resin, and I can pour up to 1 centimeter. I also have a promo code for their website. If you use my code Petra, then you get 10% discount on all their websites. So that's great. So all the information to my promo code you can find in the description box below this video. So I'm very curious how the chameleon pigment pens will look if I take the inlay molds out. And of course, I've listed all the supplies I've used in this video at the end of the video, but also in the description box below this video with the links to the websites. So if you're curious where I buy my materials, then you need to check out the description box. Going to add more resin because the mold is not filled enough. Yeah, and if you pour all the way up to the top, then the geode tray will be about 1 centimeter. So that's a nice thickness. And I'm pouring from up high, because that way you don't get that much air bubbles in your resin. I must say, in this resin are not a lot of air bubbles. Adding a little bit more of the green-black color. And then I'm almost done. Need to let this dry for at least 24 hours before I can take them out of the mold. So we are almost 24 hours later, and now I'm going to take the geode trays out of the mold. I need to be very careful because they are still bendy. And hopefully they will look nice. Turning it around. Yeah, what I can already see is that the abalone shells are not that visible. And also the glitter lines disappeared in some parts. But it's no problem. It's an experiment. So I think what I will do the next time is on top of the abalone shells add some clear resin and then the opaque resin. So the first inlay mold is out and it looks amazing. I'm so pleased with these chameleon pigment pens. Now the other inlay mold, and that one is also so nice. Very nice. You can already see the shifting of the colors. Yeah, I lost some parts of the glitter lines, but I can add them on top of resin. That's no problem. So I will add them again. But yeah, what I already mentioned, the next time I think I'm going to add some clear, a thin layer of clear, and then I will add the opaque resin. Maybe that will work. But I'm very pleased with the experiment of my chameleon pigment pens. It looks so pretty. Also adding the blue line again. And the structure of the inlay molds is amazing. I especially like the one on the right side, the crushed ice. Very nice. So this side will also get a heat-resistant layer, not on the inlay effect, the crushed ice, but also the leather. If I pour resin on top of it, then the structure will be gone. So that's not what I want. And the pigments will not come up, the chameleon pigments. So I only add a heat-resistant layer on the outside. And what I always do is use a silicone gummy and then prevent that it will leak on top of the structure. So this is the end result. What I already mentioned, I've added a heat resistant layer. Yeah, I'm trying to show you the color shift effect, the chameleon effect. Yeah, you can see it. From blue to purple, green, magenta, little bit of orange. There you can see the blue green. So nice, really nice. I'm very pleased with these chameleon pigment pens, and I hope I can list them this month to my Etsy shop. For now 6 colors, but I'm so happy. Very nice. Let me know what you think of these chameleon pens, if you find them just as nice as I find them. Again, I'm trying to show you in different light. Hopefully you can see it. Yeah, I'm very happy with this experiment. So if you like what I'm doing, consider to subscribe. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up if you like this video. All the information to the supplies I've used you can find in the description box below this video. Also the link to my Etsy shop. And also for the people in the USA and Canada, the Etsy shop of my associate, Evelyn Schaefer. So I want to thank you all again for watching. and hopefully I will see you in the next video. Bye!